Hi friends, welcome back to our channel. If you remember, in our last video we asked where to put the mud or soil to minimize load on the back of the person. Answer is so obvious. The closer the load to the wheel, the lighter the load on the back of the man. We know this from our experience as well. Of course, if we at least worked once in a village. But explaining this in terms of statics is also very important. Cart wheel and hand of the man will be supports in this case. If I assume that all the load is applied to the wheel, or as close as possible to the wheel, all of the or most of the load will be carried by it. In the second case, load is closer to the man. If I take moment about any point, I will get larger load on man than on the wheel. Today is the day of the truss. It is a structure composed of slender members joined together at their end points. Examples of trusses are here, shown in below. By the way, my friends, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and also write your opinions in comments below. To design trusses, we have to know three assumptions. First, loads are applied at the joints. It can either be a tension or it can either be compression. There can never be transverse load on the member itself if there is one. For example, self-weight, it must be reassigned to joints such as in this figure. Half of the load will go to the top joint, other half to the bottom one. But why? For this, we must also know other assumptions. Second assumption is single force members. Here, we assume that there is no transverse load, which is shear, or there is no moment. Remember this, trusses only have force in its axial direction. The reason for this is that truss is a very slender member, which doesn't have enough stiffness or strength to carry shear moment. You can think of this like a rope, although truss can be very stiff member. Third assumption is that members are pin connected. If you remember from previous courses, we have three major supports. They are fixed, roller and pinned. Pin or hinge doesn't carry any moment, so it is moment free. If we would have transverse load on truss member, it would act like a beam and it will result in moment on the joints. In real life, trusses are not pin connected exactly. However, for the sake of ease and because usually there is no transverse load on the truss system, these assumptions are very appropriate. We have laid all the basic information for truss, but we have one thing left to finish, and that is statical determinacy. How do we check this? Basically, it is checking if number of equations you have is enough for number of unknowns. Let us try to count the unknowns first. We know that we always have reactions for any rigid body in equilibrium. In our case, we have a pin support and a roller support. So we have two reactions for pin support, X and Y reactions, but for roller support, we have only Y reaction. Total of three reaction unknowns. And we also know that a truss member is a single force member. We have one force per member. In our case, we would have three unknowns from members, total of six unknowns. Unknowns are done, now let's try to find number of equilibrium equations. In general, we have three equilibrium equations, for X and Y direction and for moment. But truss members are all straight axial force members lying in the same plane. That is why moment equilibrium is satisfied at the joint or pin. And we are just left with two equilibrium equations at the joint. And remember, for any truss member to be statically determined, we need to have number of members plus number of reactions must be equal to 2 times number of joints.